A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to the chief priests and elders of the people, "What is your opinion? A man had two sons. He came to the first and said, 'Son, go out and work in the vineyard today.' He said in reply, 'I will not,' but afterward changed his mind and went. The man came to the other son and gave the same order. He said in reply, 'Yes, sir,' but did not go. Which of the two did his father's will?" They answered, "The first." Jesus said to them, "Amen, I say to you, tax collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in a way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him." The Gospel of the Lord.
From where does glory come? Does it come from what we achieve? Well, the answer to that question is no. Glory comes through what we give up for the sake of another. An exaltation comes when the other does not deserve what we gave up on their behalf. You say, the Lord's way is not fair. Indeed. For the past 3 weeks, we have been listening to Matthew's gospel present teachings that are hard to swallow. 2 weeks ago, we learned that for a Christian, forgiveness is not an option. We are required to forgive those who wrong us. Our salvation depends on it. Though the standard number of expected times to offer forgiveness was 4, Peter was onto something when he asked Jesus if 7 times was enough, 7 representing perfection. Astonishingly, Jesus said even this was not enough. We must forgive 77 times. We must forgive as God forgives. Many of us reject this notion, rationalizing that God will understand. Well, in reality, God will not. Last Sunday, we heard that our sense of fairness cannot be imposed upon God. "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways," says the Lord. A person who lives a godless life, but is truly repentant at the last hour, will receive the same reward as those of us who have struggled to remain faithful our entire lives. Our sense of fairness is violated by this thought. We learned, however, that God is both just and generous. But sometimes our human sense of fairness, my friends, stands in the way of God's generosity. God will be just with the faithful and generous with the sinner who comes around, even if it is the last hour. Today we are once again confronted with the reality that God's ways are not ours, but we are expected to learn God's ways and live by them. Those who lived in the Middle Eastern Mediterranean culture lived by a code of honor and shame. We must remember this when reading today's parable. The commandment is to honor our father and mother. In the parable, the father asks each son to go to the vineyard to get some work done. The first son said in reply, "I will not." This was absolutely awful. The son brought shame to his father by refusing his request. The second son respectfully said in reply, "Yes, sir." This son was respectful of his father and polite. In the Middle Eastern system of honor, the second son, who was respectful, would have been considered the good son, even though he never did as he was told. He was good because he was respectful. It would have made no difference to Jesus' listeners that the first son, though disrespectful, ultimately did as he was told. That meant nothing in the face of bringing shame to his father. Jesus surprised the crowd with a different question than they were expecting. Which of the two did his father's will. They would have wondered, what difference does it make which son actually did what he was told? The first son was disrespectful, and that should be the end of it. It would have killed the crowd to acknowledge that the one who shamed his father was actually the one who did the father's will. A group of chief priests and elders had just questioned Jesus' authority to teach in the temple area. By asking such a question, they actually violated the code of honor and brought shame to Jesus by questioning his authority. Jesus responded to their question with the question asked in the parable. He made it clear that the appearance of authority can be deceiving. The chief priests and elders appeared to have authority, but they did not. They appeared to be doing the will of the Father, but in reality, they were not. Tax collectors and prostitutes, the most despised of all supposed sinners, who worked to change their lives according to Jesus' teaching, were those who were really doing the will of the Father. Appearances do not count with God. Reality does. Glory was thought, and normally is thought, to come from achievement, like a general who conquers a foreign army or a scientist who makes a great discovery. St. Paul points out, however, that this is not God's way to glory. With God, our glory comes by what we surrender, not by what we achieve. My sisters and brothers, contrary to our achievement-driven culture, we must empty ourselves and take the form of a slave. We must give up everything of our own will to do the will of the Father. From this comes real glory, not merely an appearance of glory. Yes, this is hard, but it is asked of us, and eventually, we must go to the vineyard, as the Father asked. In your surrendering of self, may the Lord give you peace.